Welcome to the online lecture series of Turbo Machines. Here is Professor Lakshman Mane. This is lecture on centrifugal pumps, part 8, that is cavitation. NPSH means net positive suction head, maximum suction lift, and selection of centrifugal pumps. I acknowledge my sincere thanks to the following authors and courtesy for being used these concepts to make this video session. In this session, you will be able to explain cavitation in centrifugal pump. You will be able to explain NPSH of centrifugal pump. You will be able to explain maximum suction lift of centrifugal pump, and you will also be able to explain factors of selection of centrifugal pump. Let us discuss about vapor pressure. Vapor pressure is defined as the pressure at which liquid molecules will turn into vapor. Here we can observe that in order for the water to boil, the vapor pressure of the liquid must be equal to the atmospheric pressure. So here from this graph, we can see on a horizontal axis there are values of temperature in degree Celsius. On vertical axis there are values of vapor pressure in bar. So when the water is heated in an open vessel at atmospheric pressure, then it is boiling at 100 degree Celsius. So corresponding to 100 degree Celsius temperature, the pressure is 1 bar, that is atmospheric pressure. Now when this process is carried out in a closed vessel, then pressure inside the vessel is increasing because of accumulation of vapor which are adding to the space inside the vessel over the liquid surface, and because of that their vapor pressure is more. So this pressure is, for example, suppose 2 bar. So corresponding value of temperature at 2 bar is 120 degree Celsius. Similarly, when the pressure inside the vessel is reduced, say up to 0.5 bar, then water will boil or vaporize at 80 degree Celsius temperature. Means what? There is linear relation between vapor pressure and temperature. So this concept is very useful in pump. Let us see cavitation in centrifugal pump. So here you can see these are the effects of cavitation on the impeller. Now why it is so? We will see. Cavitation is formation of vapor bubbles in the water flowing through the impeller through the centrifugal pump. It occurs when the static pressure of the water falls below its vapor pressure. Means pressure inside the pump when it's falling below vapor pressure, then obviously it is starting to vaporize. So in low pressure region, vapor bubbles are formed because of pressure below vapor pressure. When they reach region of high pressure, they get suddenly collapsed. The sudden growth and collapse of these vapor bubbles cause the pitting action. means erosion, on metal surfaces which are exposed to the cavitating water. So this phenomenon is called as cavitation. So you can observe here, this is what cavitation effect, which is on the impeller. So we will discuss about it, effects of cavitation. It produces extensive erosion of the impeller and casing, thus lead to failure of pump housing. It causes additional noise and vibrations. It changes the flow pattern, decreases flow and pressure inside the pump, and it increases power consumption. So these are the adverse effects of cavitation. Now, what are the different methods to avoid cavitation? We can avoid cavitation by selecting impeller of low specific speed. It can be avoided by selecting material of impeller which resists effect of cavitation. So cast steel is better than cast iron. Cavitation can be minimized by polishing the surface. Use of impeller blade coated with stainless steel. Now we will discuss about net positive suction head, means NPSH. The term NPSH is dimensional parameter used in pump industry to check cavitation in pump. NPSH is the net head that is required to make the liquid flow through the suction pipe from the sump to the impeller. Net positive suction head is the difference between the absolute pressure head at inlet of the pump and vapor pressure head absolute value. So here in this diagram we can see this is a pump located. Here are the different head terms. So here you can see this is gross pumping head, this is HA. On this side these are the parameters on suction side and these are the parameters on delivery side. So in next we will take your simple diagram for the well understanding. Here you can see this is the water surface level. This is the suction pipe which is deep inside the water. So here is a point A and impeller is located at point 1 and discharge means delivery is at point 2. So let the various parameters which are here. P1 is absolute pressure at inlet of pump. PA is absolute atmospheric pressure. PV is vapor pressure of the liquid at the impeller. So HA means PA by W, that is atmospheric pressure head. HV means PV by W, that is vapor pressure head, where W is equal to rho g, means specific weight of water. HS is a static suction head. HFS is losses. HFS are the losses in suction up to pump inlet. V square by 2G is velocity head in suction pipe. So as per the definition, NPSH can be written as it is equal to absolute pressure head at inlet of pump at this point is P1 by W minus vapor pressure head means PV by W. So mathematically, now we can write NPSH is equal to P1 by W minus PV by W. Here, this is the notation used for NPSH, HSV. Now, arranging this equation, we can write P1 by W is equal to PV by W plus HSV, say equation number 1. Now, from the diagram, at this point, pressure here, P1 by W, this value will be what? This total value is PA by W minus the values which are above these lines, means HS, HFS and V square by 2G. Thus here it is written P1 by W is equal to PA by W minus in the bracket HS plus HFS plus V square by 2G, bracket complete, say equation number 2. Now if you observe equation number 1 and 2, left side is same. So we can equate right hand side of the both equations. So from equation 1 and 2, we can write PV by W plus HSV on one side is equal to PA by W minus bracket HS plus HFS plus V square by 2G bracket complete on other side. As per the definition, PV by W plus HSV. Okay, so here this PV by W we can take on the right side. So here HSV is equal to equation is PA by W minus this bracket summation of these three terms minus PV by W. Now all these are what one kinds of heads. So we can have here for them this HSV is equal to HA means PA by W. These are what HS means summation of HS plus HF plus HFS plus V square by 2G. And this is PV by W means HV. So where HA is already we have discussed atmospheric pressure head of water, HS is suction pressure head and HV is vapor pressure corresponding to water temperature. Now NPSH required and NPSH available. So NPSH required is the minimum value of NPSH that pump should develop to avoid cavitation. It depends upon capacity, speed and efficiency of pump. NPSH available means it is the practical value of NPSH the pump must generate under operating conditions, that is pressure, temperature, surface finish, etc. In order to avoid cavitation, the available NPSH should be greater than the required NPSH. Now we will see maximum suction lift of pump. So the same diagram we will take here. So in this diagram, the height between free liquid surface and pump axis. So this is the pump axis. This is free liquid surface. Height difference between that is HS. So this is what maximum suction lift of pump. So maximum suction lift is the limiting value of the absolute suction pressure at inlet of impeller without causing cavitation, means it decides the value in order to avoid the cavitation of HS. So here applying Bernoulli's equation between point A which is at liquid surface and point 1 which is at impeller. So we can write Bernoulli's equation, say that total energy, this is total energy at point A and this is total energy at point 1. So total energy is already we know that summation of pressure head, velocity head and potential head. So at point A, PA by W is the pressure head Vs square by 2g is velocity head and za is datum head or elevation is equal to PV by W means vapor pressure head, Vs square by 2g means velocity head on suction side, Z1 is elevation at point 1 and HFS is loss due to friction on suction side. Now from the diagram, if we take this line as a reference or datum line, so value of ZA is 0. Value of Z1 will be what? HS. And at the inlet or at the point A, the water which is here stationary, so its velocity is 0. So substituting these values, we find here PA by W means HA, VA square by 2G is 0, ZA is 0, PV by W is HV, VA square by 2G, Z1 is HS plus HFS. So by arranging the equations, we can have this equation HS is equal to HA minus HV minus VA square by 2G minus HFS. So this is the equation for maximum suction lift of pump. So suction height of any pump means this height should not be more than HS. Okay, so if it will be more than HS, so obviously what will happen? The pressure inside this point will fall below vapor pressure and cavitation will occur. Okay, now we will see Thomas cavitation factor. In order to avoid cavitation, PS by W should be greater than or equal to vapor pressure, means suction pressure. Suction pressure head should be greater than suction vapor pressure head. So here it should be at least equal to PS by W is equal to PV by W. Now already we have seen suction height of any pump should not be more than HS. So suction lift, this is a formula, PS by W is equal to, this can be written as HS, suction lift, that is equal to HA minus HV minus V square by 2G minus HFS. This already we have derived from the last derivation. NPSH also we know, that is what, HA minus HV minus HS. So now we will put here for the HS these all the quantities. So here HA minus HV minus, for HS this HA, this HV, V square by 2G, HFS. But because of this minus sign here, the signs which are here are changed. So here you find that HA will get cancelled to each other, HV also will get cancelled to each other. So NPSH is equal to remain V square by 2G plus HFS, net positive suction head. So can be written in the other terms also. So Thoma suggested a cavitation factor to determine the zone where pump can work safely. The value of cavitation factor, so here is cavitation factor, which is given by, this is a Greek symbol sigma, which is equal to, it is a ratio of what, NPSH to manometric head, is HSV by HM. NPSH is what, HA minus HV minus HS divided by HM, where already these terms already we have discussed in last slides. Now here sigma C is critical value of cavitation factor. So when cavitation factor value is less than critical value of cavitation factor, means sigma C, cavitation occurs. Means to avoid cavitation, value of cavitation factor sigma should be greater than critical value. Okay, so in this way cavitation factor helps us in the design of pump. So sigma C is obtained from the manufacturer catalog, So it is given by pump manufacturer. We will see now one numerical. Test on a pump model indicate Thomas cavitation factor is 0.1. A homologous unit is installed at a location where atmospheric pressure is 0.91 bar and vapor pressure as 0.095 bar absolute value, and is to pump water against a head of 25 meter. So what is the maximum permissible suction lift or head? Neglect frictional losses in the suction pipe. So given data, here vapor pressure is given, means PV value in bar. We know that vapor pressure head HV is equal to what? PV by W. Now this is a value given in bar. So we need this in Pascal, means Newton per meter square. So multiply this bar value by 10 raised to 5 divided by specific weight of water in Newton per meter cube, that is 9810. So we find value of HV, means vapor pressure head, in meter. Manometric feed is given. So here in this diagram we can see this is a suction pipe, this is what HS, this is manometric head, delivery end, this is water surface, on that atmospheric pressure acting, that is given in bar 0.91. So atmospheric pressure is 0.91 bar. Convert that value in head, atmospheric head means PA by W. Again similarly we convert 0.91 bar into Pascal by multiplying it with 10 raised to 5 divided by value of specific weight. So we find value of HA is equal to in meter. Now Thomas cavitation factor formula is HA minus HS minus HV divided by HM. So in this formula the values which we know, all these we put. So cavitation factor 0.1, HA is calculated over here, then HV is calculated in last slide, and HM is given in meter. So from this calculation we find this what suction lift 6.63 meter. So this is what maximum permissible suction lift value. Okay, means pump cannot be located above this height in order to avoid the cavitation. So maximum permissible limit of location of pump from the water surface or with respect to water surface is what 6.63 meter. Okay, so this is what help of this Thomas cavitation factor, okay, in deciding pump location. Now we will see about selection of centrifugal pumps. We know that specific speed is used in comparing the different types of pumps and is also used for pump selection. So here we find the table in which range of specific speed and respective type of pump to be used given. So here you can see for the range of 10 to 30 specific speed, type of pump suitable is slow speed radial flow pump. For 31 up to 50 speed, medium speed radial flow pump is suitable. For the range 51 to 80, high speed radial pump flow is suitable. For the range 81 to 160, mixed flow pumps are to be used. And from 160 to 500 specific speed, axial flow pumps are to be used. So specific speed is calculated from the values of discharge Q, head H and speed N. So this formula already we have seen in last videos, that is specific speed is equal to N into square root of Q divided by HM, means manometric head raised to 3 by 4. Depending upon type of impeller, the pump is selected for particular operation. Say, type of impeller. So there are various types. See, shrouded type impellers, which are used for pumping fresh and clean water. Unshrouded type impellers are used for pumping solid liquid mixture. Mixed flow impellers are used for deep well or submersible pumps. So, data required for selection of pump is number of units required, capacity of pump required, selection and discharge condition, total head required, nature of the liquid to be pumped, power available to drive the pump, and location of installation of a pump. So, by using this data, pump selection can be done. So, at the end of this session, you can explain cavitation in centrifugal pump. You can explain net positive suction head of centrifugal pump. You can explain maximum suction lip of centrifugal pump, and you can explain factors of selection of centrifugal pump. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.